Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video, we'll be starting with this JPEG bit of clip art over here, and then using a Photoshop Elements Remove White Background trick, we'll get it to this stage here, where we have just the lines left, and then transparency, and then I'll show you the right way to add color back into that image, giving you the most flexibility and freedom. If you enjoy this video, make sure you click on like and share. You can also support my channel through Patreon. Don't forget to subscribe, as I'm doing a lot of videos every single week. There's my current list. I may even add additional videos in the off days in there. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. There's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Let's start this project off just by getting these two files out of the way. There we go. Now this is just a basic JPEG image. It's black lines on a white background. As you can see, it's all one layer over here. The kind of thing that you'll easily find all over the place on the internet, doing a little internet search for imagery. Now, fairly easy to remove a background. If you just wanted us to kind of clear that stuff out there, just grab the magic wand, hit that, and hit delete. And you'll remove a lot of stuff. It's not really the best way to go, though. There's a much better way of doing a clean out, so you have a nice clean transparency. You don't have little artifacts showing other potential problems. Let me show you how that's done. We'll first start off here with a copy of this layer. I tend to like always making duplicates of my background layer, leave the background layers untouched when I'm working on projects. So here's our copy. Now the idea here is we'll be making a selection of just the black lines using the magic wand and then use that to make a layer mask. Now when you do this, you want a fairly low number down here on tolerance. The default is 32. Now the reason for that, if I zoom in here on the edge of this white image, get real nice and tight and close, there we go. You can see here that it's not all pure black. Right along that edge, we have some gray values. This is the anti-aliasing coming in here to give us nice smooth looks on the edges without any real pixelation. But that gray edge tends to show up as an outline if you just make a straight selection and your number is too high on that magic wand tool. Let's go back to fit screen. There we are. So you want to keep your tolerance fairly low. You know, 10 is okay. You may even go down as low as 7. This will still give you some gray tones, but it'll be a lot closer. And then we'll fix that in a second step. Okay, so magic wand, real low tolerance. We're set at the new selection over here. I have contiguous unchecked. That's because you want to grab all of the black in the whole picture, not just what's touching. And then come into some nice easy area right there. Select that. And that should select all of your black in the image and none of your white. Then just go up to the layer mask tool right here, click on layer mask, and that gives you a layer mask blocking out the white. Now, the reason for doing this as a layer mask is I can turn the layer mask on and off and I'm still back to my original image. I can also come in and adjust the layer mask if I need to by painting. If I paint white, it shows more of the original image. If I paint in black, it hides part of the original image. So that really helps on that one. Okay, so there's our background with the layer mask. What I want though at this point is just the image with transparency. So let's go up to the move tool. I tend to always go back to the move tool. It's just a safe tool to be on. So back here, and let's make a copy of this layer. So right click and you can do a duplicate layer right there. There we go. And then hide this. The reason why I'm doing this step is in case I want to go back to this and work with that layer mask, I have that saved as a step. Okay, on this one, right click and then simplify layer. What that does is it collapses the layer mask down onto the original layer and leaves us with the image with transparency. Now we should have a little bit of white outline. Let me show you what we'll have in there. If I go back down to this layer and put a new layer above this layer, there we go. Let's fill that layer with black. And you can see in there, very, very thin little outline. That is caused by that little bit of gray scale around the black shapes that we looked at previously. Now the way you fix that, and it's pretty easy to do, and it helps if you have this layer down here so you can really see what's going on. Let's go up to Enhance, come down to Adjust Lighting and Levels, and grab the left side, the black side, and just pull it all the way to the right. There we go. And that converts all of your color values, all of your values that are in your image into black. So everything is now up here black. We can show that with the preview. There it is, the original. There is the preview. Choose OK, and that's now taken care of. Okay, we can just hide that black layer. We're done with that. Now if I show and hide this layer here, you'll see that there's just a slight thickening of the image. Very, very slight, not really noticeable. So that's all set. Now we have a nice clean background, nice clean image, nice clean edges. They should all be nice pure black, clear to the edges. We're ready to put our color in. Now the way I like doing the color is by using color layers with layer masks again. Let's just zoom in on the top. I'm going to pull this wide a bit here. There we go. And let's zoom in on the leaves and the stem. There we are. And let's make a selection. Grab the polygonal lasso tool. Make sure it's set at new over here. There's no need to have any feathering on this. I'll set that at 0. Okay. Now, you want to make a lasso inside of the black area. So stay inside the black. It doesn't really matter where you are in the black, as long as you're in the black, and then work around the outline of your image. Now, depending upon the complexity of your image, that's going to determine how long this particular step takes. This is a fairly simple image, which is one reason why I chose this one, so that this doesn't take too long on this video. But just make a nice little selection staying inside of the black line. Now, if you get down to an area like this, up against the edge, just hold the space bar down. You can then move the image and then continue your work. So what we're doing is we're just making a selection around the parts that will be green, and we'll then use that to do our colorization. Now right in here, those areas there, those should be in red, and then here's our leaf in behind as green. So just take your time, make a nice little selection. Now when you're using this tool, the polygonal lasso tool, don't click too quickly. If you do, it's going to collapse your selection and you'll have to start over again. So make sure each click is a distinctly separate click and you're not doing any double clicking, which causes that collapse issue. And then again, just work around. Now down here, that bottom leaf is pure black, so I can just ignore that since we're caring about the clear parts on the leaves in here. And just continue working on around. And once this is done, we'll be able to use this selection to make a very easy automatic layer mask. Okay, spacebar again. And just about finished with this step. As you can see, it's really pretty quick. Not a big deal at all. And easy because you have that whole thickness to work in inside there. You don't really need to have any kind of special accuracy on this. Go back to your starting point. There's the selection. Now come down to the layer underneath your image layer. Go up to Layer, come down to New Fill Layer and Solid Color. Leave that unchecked. Choose OK. Comes in as your original foreground color. We want to have green in here, so here's some greens. Let's just do it like that. Find a nice green color. And notice what happened. As soon as I made this fill layer, it automatically used that selection to give me a layer mask over there. Choose OK. Now there are two reasons for wanting the layer mask. The first one is I can go back and I can change that shape very easily. If I had messed up, I can easily change that shape. For instance, right down here, that really should be clear as opposed to green. Easy to fix. I'm on the layer mask side. White shows, you can see our leaves in here. Black hides, that's everything else. So all I have to do is come in and make a little selection around that one spot. Again, I'm on the layer mask itself. Let's change our colors here to our defaults. And let's set black in the foreground. Grab the paintbrush. Make a little bit larger brush size so you can see that. There it is. And then just paint right in there. And that colorizes that part of the layer mask black, which gives us that clear for our image. Okay, we'll go ahead and then deselect. So real easy to do. That's one reason for that. It's easy to adjust what's being shown in color just by changing your layer mask. Other reason for this is that it makes it very easy to change the color. Just double click on the color icon and choose a different color. So you can come in very quickly, very easily, change your color. And if you want a gradient in here instead of a solid color, when you're making that layer, just come up here to layer, come down to new fill layer, and choose gradient instead of solid color. Okay, let's now do the strawberry down below. Same exact process. We'll go back here to our polygonal lasso tool. Let's make a nice little polygon lasso right around the strawberry. Again, just staying inside the black area. That's all you have to do. And spacebar to move the image. Here we are. Let's just work clear on the bottom. And then back up to the top, we'll take care of those, the bottoms of the leaves up there. Don't worry about an overlap because these aren't going to be overlapping since they're separate areas because of the design of the artwork. Okay, quickly, easily, just right up along the edge over here. And continue on up around. These longer areas, I can go for longer line segments, obviously. And inside these bigger areas here makes it much easier. And just right around the bottoms of the leaves in here. Right over the top right there. Get back over to the starting point. Now this will give the whole thing as a nice solid red as soon as we make our layer mask. There we go. Now, as you just saw, when we did the new color, it automatically made this the foreground color. You can pre-choose your color if you want to. Just go over here and choose your color ahead of time. Like that. Choose OK. Now, as we go up here to the layer, new fill layer, solid color, it automatically fills with whatever color you have down there on your foreground color. And there it is. I can go one step further if I wanted to and do all these little areas in here, make another layer for all those areas and do those in brown. If you're doing that, if you're making like separate areas, just make sure that you're on the add option down here in the polygonal lasso tool. That way you can add in separate areas. Let me just do just a couple of these so you can see what I'm talking about. So there's one, and right over here we'll do two. So you can see here, if I have this on the add option, it allows me to do selected areas that are not touching, that are not all part of one area. Just make sure you go back to the beginning point. So to complete this step, of course, I go through and make all the rest of these their own selections for each one of those seeds. We'll stick with just these three. Go up to layer, come down to new fill layer, solid color, choose OK. Now it's using the previous color we had down there. Let's just go through and find something a bit more on the brown sides. There we go, there's our nice brown. Now you may want to take this further just for some more separation in there. A bit darker on those, and choose OK. So exact same step on these three, really. But there it is, that's how you come in and properly remove a white background. And then the best way to apply your color after you have that, which gives you the most flexibility in the future for making changes or adjustments down the road if you want to. So there it is. Removing a white background and then colorizing a black and white line drawing.